I am under wreck. Leamington Spa. Leamington Spa. Station interchange.
Okay. basically, I read here because I'm quite concerned about my kids. Basically, I got to shoot them. I got 50 of the course today. So at the moment, I don't know where they live. So I can't get contact with them. I don't know if there's a dad moving house, so I picked up dad's number or even know where they live. So I'm just ringing you guys because I'm quite concerned, quite worried of them safety. I'm the mother. At the moment, I'm on a bus, which because I got harassments over me, and I'm not feeling safe enough to say my children's name. So I'll just ring you guys because it's half past four, and you guys are gonna be closing off an hour. So I just was asked to ask you guys if you can any number, any chance to make appointments with somebody face to face, so I can speak about my problems with somebody of your staff members. To be honest with you, I don't know at the moment because I don't think they got a social service at the moment involved. But we had a social service involved with us before because the kids was with me. But because my depression and my depression, they said I'm a good mother, but because my depression, I couldn't stay with them for long term. So they give 50 of custody to the dads. But at the moment, I think they're not safe because the dad is working and the dad pay babysitting to look after the kids while work. So I don't know if them babysitters got diplomas or they're professional enough qualifications to look after my children. So at the moment, I'm not feeling safety or happy with the people being look after my children while my baby's dad is at work.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah.
11 to Leamington Spa.
Repeat the number you gave me because I tried ring them and they said is not a number available. The number I got is 0190. Is that correct? Yeah, I understand that, but I try ring them before I ring you guys and the number is not available. They said this number is not available at the moment. So I don't know what I should do. That's why I ring you back, because the number is not available. Hello? Hello? Like I said before, a few years ago, maybe 7 years ago, maybe 7 or 10 years ago, I had so basically I talked with the police about it, and the police saying they only can come out if it's emergency. So basically like if my child is attacked right now and while I'm there and see it, then the police can come in out. Otherwise, I said it's you guys have to talk to this one. Okay. I don't mind give my name. My name is Andrea. I just got consent to give my kid my children's name. I don't mind give mine. My name, I don't mind. My name is Andrea Mora. My date of birth, 23rd January 1999. I don't mind actually say my name right away. While I get consent, I give my children names and my children's birth. That's I don't mind consent. To be honest with you, it's not about that qualification or qualification. It's about safety of my child. So if my child is with somebody who's tried sexual abuse on him, it's not safety for him really. So me as a mother, I think my kids, my children, are victims of sex abuse. And my children being sex abuse. And they not tell me, and I don't believe, because they not tell me, I don't believe they talk to their dad either. So no one knows about it. But I know about it. I know about it because I've been through that before, so I know my children, so I know exactly what's going on at the moment. So what the police said is, I said that to the police, about what the conversation I have with you, I had with the police, but the police saying there's a case to deal with source and service, right now, like basically saying they're just coming out of emergency, it's you guys have to do it because it's your job to save the children till that's what they said. I don't know, I think the responsibility is police, but police said this, SOFA said this. Okay, by somebody to look after them, yeah. I don't know, I think he's a male. Thank you. Children, so that way they legalize themselves.
Westwood Way.
That's what they try to do. They're such a attract to as a mentor in Malaya. But who is she anyway?
11 to Leamington Spa.
Thank you.
left to Leamington Spa. Next stop, University Interchange. The second campus.
Thank you.
That's a good idea. Catch them all. Yeah, I'm still here. Please, you can transfer me that because I tried ringing that number and this is not available. That's why probably not go through as well. Probably they're not in the service today. Yes, because I don't give up on this. I need help, my children, and my children need help, need protection right now. So, they with dad, they're supposed to be with dad, but I don't know where they are right now. That's why I contact you guys, because I need the help. I need to know where my kids is, because they're not safe. Yes, I did, but the police saying is have to be with you guys. Yes, I talked with them about everything, and they said because it's with the children and it's not things happen right now. They said they can't come if, because these things happened before. They said it's with you guys I have to talk with, and then you guys then transfer or whatever calls to them. That's what they said, I have to be with you guys first. Yeah, they're born in our hospital and they are, they live in Leamington Spa. Yeah.
Thank you.
Chibbetts Hall Campus. Eleven to Leamington Spa.
Thank you.
Are you in loudspeakers? One second, don't talk now because you're in loudspeaker. I take out loudspeaker now. Yeah, so basically I'm on a bus now and I got harassments over me. So I got people follow me right now. And you know, people robbed my document because my document's been robbed last year. And someone's scamming my name. So the scammers, which is illegal people, they're not legal in the country, so they've been harassing me, and they try to make, because they know, they're quite connect, they work for the government, because they work for the government, they basically, they know I've been in mental hospital last year, so they try to take that a chance, as make, as tell around people, you know, people try helping me in the life. They try tell them I'm a liar and a mentor. But the people go through, the people they tell that is people they do the same thing.
11.
So they do that to everybody. So, and that's why this game quite dangerous and quite worried for me as a mother. Because I'm not safe, and because I'm not safe, because this, because the, this is all because the documents. So because they want my documents, and now they get catch up. Now they want to destroy, they want to basically kill me and my children. So what they try to do, because they know I know the truth, so they know they can't touch me. So what they try to do is make me as a liar and as a bad mother or mental or something like that, so they can adopt them, and through that they can legalize themselves through that. But the thing is, I don't think my go through all that just to make these people legal when I've been through all that already. Also, my kids now have to go through gender abuse and sexual abuse because these people decide to use my kids to be legal, really. So,
11.
When
Leamington Scott.
Yeah. No, my children never been adopted. I didn't been adopted as a child, but my children never been adopted. No, my children live with the dads. The children, my children live with me. The dads. I got 50 of her goes to the. They can't be adopted without my consent because I got 50 of her goes to me. So, to take that 50 of her goes to me, they have to touch me first. They can't do things on my behalf without my presence. So yeah. So no, they didn't been adopted. But they try to do that. Because basically it's people, you should know that. Sometimes exist people, I believe you got that in your building, like legal, illegal people do the job as a charities. Does that make sense? Because they do the job as a charities. Oh, okay, do you want to know my name? Do you like to know my name? Okay, my name is Andrea. Andrea Moura, M-O-U-R-A. No, M-O-U-R-A.
Leamington Scott.
I'm quite I speak English, so I quite understand. I don't need to translate because I speak English. I'm sorry if you can't understand me because I speak English. So I like to know. Basically, my name been scamming. My documents been scamming, and it's because my name's been scamming.
11 to Leamington Scott.
My name, my insurance number, my name, my ID. They scamming all of me, and. What they do with them, they've been holidays, they've been in hotels on my name, they've been living good on my name, and on my name. And like I said, it's quite dangerous because I got people harassing me, and I got people listening to the conversation of us, and they, while I'm talking with you, they said something like that. And they just said to themselves, well, these people can prove that these people listen to them. What they said is these people, they are illegal. And they said they talking to me and said, what you gonna do? There's nothing you can do because they let you hold it. You're not even gonna listen here, because we pay them to listen us, basically. So this is quite difficult for me to. And it's not just my, and then the problem, yes I do, and the problem is not just my children, they do that, they do it to other children, they do to shield, to English children as well, because they said they don't like English, they don't like English people, but on the end of the day, if they don't like English people, what they do in England? Why they rob other people? Yeah, why they rob other people documents? They don't like England, so go back home. You know, don't come and rob my documents to be able to stay in England if you don't like England. You know. So if you don't like England, what are you doing here? Go to jail or go back to your country? You can't just go around and destroy all the children around. Destroy all the children because they're innocent. That's what these people have been doing, because the children, they are innocent. So they're doing that. The central is the kids. So the kids scare them. So the kids do everything they want, basically, because that. And I'll have to go through all this harassment and bullying over me, because all this illegal corruption things have been happening around me. Because it's so many, and to be honest with me, this is these people work for the police. So when I complain to the police not listen to me properly the way they should, because they tried to make him as a liar. So they try to make him as a liar, so I don't have the help I needed. Yeah, that's how they would do it. And because no one listened, they're not ready to my oldest child. And now they do it to my youngest, because no one listened me when I complain about what's going on with the oldest. Because I complain about what happened to the oldest, and because no one listened me, now is the youngest going for the same thing. And to be honest, it's not fair on me go through all that, and then now my children, all the traumas that we go on our heads over these people, not even legal here. They use other people, they use it, basically they use it, other people to be able to go to school, that's what they've been doing.
Next stop, St. John's Church.
That's what I tried to say. My children, they're not safe. They at the moment, I think they are at home.
St. John's Church.
But the dad's going to go work soon. So they're going to be again with the babysitting. The person. That much my children. Well, at the moment I'm on a bus towards to Leamington Spa, because I've been traveled to Leamington Spa every day to try to see if I can see where his dad lives, if I can see my mother or my baby's dad, so I can talk to them about the situation, because I don't believe the dad knows about what's going on, because my children are never going to tell him anything, because my children are scared to talk. My children never told me either, but because I've been through that before, I know exactly how we feel it, because they are my children. Think is no normal. The brain now, they're more traumatizing, and I know it's something that they scare. So last time I saw my children was 2 months ago. So yeah. Yeah. Okay, what make me go through that is because I'm a mother and they are my own child. So I know my own child. So last time I see my child, they was with a kid, which I couldn't actually complain about because they was kids same age my son. But I see them try intimidating my son, because I listen to my son said, oh, that's my mother. And I listen that child said to my son, don't talk to her. So I know, and my child, he just starts running away from everybody. I think this is my mom. I see my child, and I see my child said, this is my mom. And then the other child said to him, don't talk to him. So I feel like something's going on here. And I believe it's not that child problem, it's their parents. So the parents of that child didn't teach the child to do to another child, really. And this all because the corruption and the irrigation we not talk about. Because they're not legal in the country. Not because at the moment I don't know which school they're going to. Because basically, we talk about maybe 10 years ago, my child was in Lillington school.
Lillington school.
St. Paul, I think that's the name of the school. So that time, my children was to live with dad already. But I was to have contact them. I was to stay with them on weekends, in the holidays that time. Because my son was 9, was 10 years old at that time. 10 or 11, I can't remember, it was around that age. So when my child was walking to the school, someone, a big one, a red big one, tried to kidnap my child. This has happened before my name is Kamet. So before my name is Kamet, someone tried to kidnap my child. But because I was a single mother and I always teach my child to not talk to no strangers. So because I was to go through bad moments, and I didn't want to explain to my child because they was too young to explain it. So all I could do is tell them to not talk with no strangers. Talk to no strangers. Even a stranger said, I know your mother. Yeah, I said to my children, I said, look, if anyone said to you, you know, they know me, you still not talk to them. You still not say nothing to them, you still not talk to them. Even they said they know me, you still not talk to them. And so my child, when they was with me, they get raised that way. So when apparently there was a man inside the van, the red van, coming from Lillington, they used to work as a building, houses. So basically, this child talked to my child, and my child said, go away, I don't know you. So apparently that person said, I know your mother. So told the teacher, and so they involved us with a service, and they put my shawl in the shawl protection. But I don't know if they are now at the moment on that situation, because I'm quite concerned, because these people, I mean, they work for social service and this is a charity. So, because they do their jobs as a charities, I'm quite concerned sometimes who I'm talking with, which portion I'm talking with, and if that makes sense.
To Leamington Spa.
Okay. Okay, yeah. Yeah, if you can save my number in the system and contact me as soon as possible, because I need you guys in my life, because I try help myself, because I try to get away of where was the dangers, but I just realize it's no point to run away because they follow me where I go. So, and because these people work for the government, they find out where my child live, and that's why this has been happening. So what I should do now to start to get a contact with my child? Oh, it's just going to hopefully it's sorted. I think it's going to be sorted now. Some friends to play with. Oh, they got plenty friends anyway. I don't know. they got plenty friends. Oh. Don't let get used and abused by these people, okay? Because you guys are new here, so don't let nobody abuse and abuse you too, okay? Look after each other, stay together, yeah? Mm-hmm. And don't let nobody, yeah, okay. No, they're the ones, they're the one. We have to talk about them. That's what it is, make justice, okay? Oh, is my name there? On a call. So we can, if they know the right job, we can report it as a neglection. Yeah, that's a good idea. Leave it. Yeah, put on YouTube. So if they know the right job, yeah. There is a neglection and that? Is racism? Yeah, do that. I don't mind my name there. It's there already anyway. Don't worry. Okay. Yeah, don't fuck on it. We're gonna do this.
Next stop, Formal.
recharged. On this journey. Please leave the bus here and make sure you have everything with you. Thank you for traveling with National Express Coventry.